Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. In this video, we're going to cover an early preview that's been posted of the April patch notes. The patch itself is probably a couple of weeks away from going live, and things could change between now and then, but let's take a look at the proposed changes and what might be coming. Starting off with the general ones, the first is a small buff to battle elephants. Not only are they becoming 10 food cheaper, but they're also getting slightly faster. The speed is probably not noticeable as it's just a 2% bump. Related to this, the Heavy Scorpion is also getting some nice changes, decreasing the cost of that upgrade and getting more HP and melee armor. We maybe should have put this under the heading of a Khmer buff, as this sounds exactly like an army composition you could see out of them. Though other civs, including Romans, Celts, or Mongols, will mix in Heavy Scorpions in different situations as well. The HP change feels like the biggest one to me, as it means Heavy Scorpions are now guaranteed to survive a direct Bombard Cannon or Mangonel shot if they're starting at full health, which is not true on the current patch. Combined with the extra armor, they're also going to hold up better against melee units in general, and given Heavy Scorpions are the least popular of the four major siege units, anything to help them out sounds good to me. The next change is to Watchtowers, dropping their wood cost from 50 to 35. Remember, at one point, this was 25 wood, so we're not in unprecedented territory. The speed of cannon galleon projectiles was then increased slightly to now half that of the Spanish, and Siege Engineers now also applies to demo ships, giving them plus 40% bonus damage against buildings. On paper, that's an extra 112 damage against docks, etc., though considering a heavy demo ship costs almost as much as a dock with a gold cost in there as well, it's not really a good idea, or at least not a cost-effective idea to use them against buildings, even with Siege Engineers. This is also exacerbated by the fact the game doesn't quite give you credit for hitting buildings head-on, counting explosions as a slight miss and taking away about 15% of the damage you should be doing. Basically, demos just aren't that good of an idea against buildings for a few different reasons. Now though, let's talk about these civilization-specific changes. The first is Armenians are giving shipwright to the Berbers. Remember, Armenians get an extra projectile on their galley line and plus one range on those with a unique tech, so their late game is very good already, even with shipwright being taken away. Meanwhile, Berbers have faster moving ships, so you get the sense they're supposed to be a bit of a water civ, and this seems like a classic case of nerfing a very good civ and buffing a mediocre one on water at the same time. Next up, for the Bengalis, they're losing Parthian Tactics, which of course gives Cavalry Archer variants some extra armor and bonus damage against the spear line. In compensation, the Wrath Chariot is getting +1/+1 armor in Castle Age, and then the full effect of Parthian Tactics as part of upgrading to the Elite version. Basically, it's just a better unit in Castle Age, and the Elite upgrade, which is already unusual for costing just food and wood, now has Parthian Tactics built into it. On the flip side, this means their Elephant Archers are no longer getting Parthian Tactics at all. Overall, Bengalis should be a little better, if anything, on 1v1 Arabia, I expect, where they're struggling the most, with the Chariot meant to be their Knight and Cavalry Archer replacement. In team games, though, the Elephant Archer spam was arguably a little too strong and carrying them in some situations, and now they'll take twice as much damage from Arbalesters as an example. They still take 25% less bonus damage and attack 20% faster with a unique tech, and when you play out the implications, this change actually makes a lot of sense. Moving on to the Bulgarians, they got a pretty simple change in that their conic training time is dropping from 19 seconds to 16. That's now roughly half the creation time of a knight, though of course you need castles or crepos to make them. The stats show they're tanking a little bit in the mid-game, and that might be what this is trying to target. Next up, for the Dravidians, they're having the cost of Woot Steel dropped, and remember, this is the tech that lets their infantry and cavalry ignore melee armor. I don't think 150 resources is going to move the needle too much, but it is a pretty key tech for them in the late game if you're going for infantry or especially the Urumi swordsmen. Dravidians are pretty weak on Arabia at the moment, but among the best civs on Nomad and Hybrid maps according to the stats, so it makes sense they'd be trying only very subtle changes to them. Moving on, the Malay are getting their Battle Elephant discount reduced by 5%. Malay certainly don't need a nerf, but remember the cost of Battle Elephants is dropping by 10 food this patch. The net result is they drop from Malay by 1 or 2 food each, but are going up by 4 gold, so it's overall a slight nerf. I don't think they're trying to tinker with Malay here at all though, and are just trying to keep Malay in the same ballpark after the Battle Elephant change. Next up is a direct nerf though to the Mongols. Their plus 30% HP bonus for light cavalry and step lancers is being dropped in Castle Age to plus 20%. That just means both units are going from 98 HP down to 92 until you hit Imperial. I definitely understand the frustration with Mongols hitting Castle Age early and that step lancers were probably too strong for Mongols. The poor light cavalry, though, was just minding its own business, and suddenly the Step Lancer entered the family, and now both units get nerfed. At the same time, this might actually be a buff to their scouts, as it's now scout line getting plus 20% instead of just light cavalry, meaning any leftover Mongol scouts get an automatic 9 HP jump when you age up. Keep in mind, both of these impacted Castle Age units also still have 12 more HP than generic ones in Castle Age, with the same late game strength. If anything, hopefully this just leads to a greater variety of units instead of Step Lancers being the default. And finally, the last change is for the Sicilians, whose bonus for 50% faster castle construction is being expanded to all fortifications, meaning walls and dungeons. The dungeon build time was then increased to offset that, with the net effect of being just slightly faster to build, with then a wood discount to match the watchtower change. This is the one tweak this patch I might take some time to warm up to. Personally, I like the Sicilians as a funky cavalry sieve ignoring bonus damage, and this just pushes them even more toward the fast castle dungeon and sergeant spam. Sicilians are actually in a pretty weird spot at the moment, and if we look at 1200 ELO and up, Sicilians are among the weakest sieves, so it makes sense to buff them, and it's also understandable to want to lean into their unique building instead of just being another cavalry sieve. The change makes a lot of sense from that perspective, and even the faster built palisade walls might stop them from getting absolutely crushed in quick games. On the flip side, they're consistently the best sieve below 850 ELO, winning almost 75% of games ending between 20 and 30 minutes. That really looks to me like lower ELO players have a hard time dealing with the Sicilian dungeon and sergeants, which is only going to be exacerbated, one would think, with faster built and cheaper dungeons. I don't know what the solution is, but there's a bit of a reverse Chinese thing going on here, with Sicilians being amazing at low ELO and way below average at higher ELOs. I'm curious what you guys think about it, as it's one of those classic trade-offs of whether you balance exclusively around high ELO or to what degree you take all ELO into account, and at least in this patch, buffing at the high end seems to be the target. So those are the changes that are on the way. Speaking of high ELO players though, an interesting thing to note is that Georgians are being left alone, for seemingly at least another patch. They jump from dead last to number 1 so far this patch for 1200 ELO and up on Arabia and all maps combined. Personally, I'm glad the devs are letting this just play out for at least a few weeks instead of making a snap decision to nerf them. Though that said, I assume their Dark Age is going to take a hit at some point. One interesting comment I saw on this topic suggested taking away 50 wood from them at the start of the game. You still get the consistent villager production and free mule cart, but you'd have to collect wood before your third house. As it stands right now, you can make 3 houses and a mill with your starting wood, with 25 wood left over, which is technically enough to go up at 19 pop or earlier without collecting wood at all. That gives high level players a ton of flexibility to go heavy on food early and worry about the wood for a barracks and stable in late Dark Age or on the way up. Minus 50 starting wood feels like a simple way to target the highly optimized scout builds that are making Georgians so dangerous at the moment in the right hands, though I'm sure the devs will consider a few ideas. That'll do it for this one though. Thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you next time.